guys, so I'm gonna be unpacking or unboxing the AVerMedia PW513. So just arrived. So this is a 94 angle camera that records 4K. I'm not gonna get into many details because there's lots of information already online. So so this is supposed to be the best by some, by, or considered by some, the best webcam in the market at the moment. So yeah, so the box looks very nice. Wow, the weight of it, like literally. Right. So this is like proper metal, except this part, the shutter, it's plastic. So the shutter covers the camera completely. You can just move it back. You have a support here to put it in the, well, the support bracket, really. Let's see what else. Right, so this opens, and it's quite... Well, you need to apply some strength to actually move it. So if I do this, see that it doesn't even move out of place. Even though that the camera is quite heavy, it doesn't move. So you have to apply some pressure, so that's going to be good. Yeah, this looks good. Looks really good. USB-C in the back, and let's see, what else is in this box? So we have the cable, it is USB-C in the camera and USB 3.1 or 3.0, yeah, so yeah, so that's good. So here we go, the Cam 513 or PW513, I apologize for the camera quality, but that's exactly why I bought this one. So hopefully our videos will have a better, well, not hopefully, for what I paid for this camera, for sure the videos are gonna have great quality after. So I'm just gonna connect it now and I'm gonna try to add it here so I can just show you guys the difference. So I'm just using a cheap camera that I bought that costed £30. It's a Xiaomi something that came with like a little tripod. Yeah, so let's just get this camera on and we're gonna put it on just so you can kind of compare it. Put it in place next to the other one. So I'm just gonna put this facing me so they're side by side. Oh, I didn't know this one did this. So just before I put it, you see how the camera is, like most cameras like these don't actually move to the sides, but this one actually does, like proper. So that's good. It also has a little bit of an angle, so you can adjust it sideways as well. But then again, you want the camera to be straight. And the dog is just making noise now. Okay. So what we're doing is here. Alright, let me just close the door. Okay, and let's connect this camera. Add it here, I need to wait for it to install, so bear with me a second. Okay. So let's see if it's installed already, so let's add this new camera, USB, oh, there you go, live streamer, okay, right, so I'm going to put them both side by side at the same size. Just so you can see the quality of both, because the more you stretch it, the more you lose quality. So let's just open it up like this and like this. Okay, as you can see, like comparing both of the cameras, the PW Hold on, let me just add here a little bit of text. So as you can see, so as you can see, the quality is much better, like much, much better on this one. You can see like the reds on the other camera are really bad. And you can't really see details of the hand when I'm doing this in the cheap camera. But in the AVerMedia, you can actually see the proper color of the hand and some of the ridges of the hand. So that's actually quite good. Look at this, getting so red, and the other one is getting so pink. Okay, so let's try to play with the settings here. Let me see. What's the software for this called? Cam Engine. Alright, so. AVerMedia. So I need to go to AVerMedia. Apparently the camera needs to be upgraded, the firmware, and we need to install the engine as well. So let's do that. Support. Download. This is center. Video capture now webcams. 4K UHD. PW13, okay, so Windows, okay, so let's see what is this, AVerMedia Cam Engine, so let's download this, and then what's the other one, Cam Light, maybe better, this is for Mac, Datasheet, okay, so let's install this, I'll share my screen as well in a second. Still installing, as you can see. Okay, that's finished. Right, let's open this software. Start to minimize. Okay, so let me just share the screen. So, I'm gonna turn off the old cheap camera now. So, we can zoom this one in. And we can actually zoom this one in as well, just so you can see how it looks. Okay, so let's just adjust it properly. Okay, like this, and I can twist it a little bit. Here we go. So you can actually see like the details in the back are actually very, very clear, which were not when I was using the other cameras. I had this one. What's the name? The Logitech Streamlabs. Streamlabs. Stream something. But I wasn't very happy with it. The USB-C failed quite a few times. the image quality was okay. I can't really compare, but well, if I was zooming in like I was just now when I was doing the unboxing, while I'm zooming in, while I'm doing something in my actual desk, that couldn't really zoom properly. Right, I can see there's a lot of red in my face. I'm just gonna try to open the window, see how does this look, because it's proper bright from the window. Kind of holds the color really well. So let's try to adjust the brightness. Okay. So the brightness is actually pretty good. Contrast. It's too black. And it's too white. So I think this is what we want really. Let's see this one. Very yellow or very red. We just want something. That's better, and the saturation, okay, maybe like this, sharpness, let's put in the maximum difference, can't really see any difference really. Trying to look at the screen and see if we can actually see the difference in the sharpness, but we can, so I'm just gonna leave it in the middle. Let's go to the advanced backlight compensator. Okay, that's actually pretty, it's good, it's very subtle. Yeah, so in terms of adjustments, this one is definitely better. The zoom. Da-da-da-da! Zoom is pretty good actually. What is this pan doing? Absolutely nothing. Let's restore this on the defaults. I'll leave everything on the default tilt. Adjust this to 60 Hz or 50 Hz. Okay, I'll just leave it off if it was off. Okay, so I'll leave it on the medium settings for now. High fluency, high quality. So let's press the high quality, see how this makes any difference. You can't really see the second window. Well done. So, here, the window, and it's this one that we want. So when you press the settings, just on the left-hand corner here, this one comes up, and you have here high fluency or high quality. I'm going to leave it on the high quality, a noise cancellation, close, and open. Okay, so that's good so far. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna change the input from the microphone to be from that camera. So it's
this one. Okay, so now the sound it's coming from the new camera. And let's try to close this shutter. So let's move this out of the way, or we can actually move it out. Put it here and hide it, and let's hide this one as well. So this is with the shutter off, the shutter on. You can actually just limit it really, but yeah, it seems to be worth the money. Hopefully it's gonna be better than the Logitech one, the stream whatever, and it's gonna actually keep working other than stopping working out of nowhere. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and make sure you subscribe to the channel, leave a like to the video, it helps a lot, and yeah, thank you for watching.